I think the big change in Greece came in last summer, where we had the big movement in the squares. There was a big turn in the fight of the working class of this. Because in the previous period, before this summer, we had many general strikes in Greece. But in the summer there was a qualitative change. Thousands of unemployed, of women working in the household, people, petty bourgeois never went on the streets to strike, came on the street to demonstrate against the memorandum. And they felt really their unity, and they felt really strong. Actually, this movement that was mainly in Sidama Square, but in all the big city squares of Greece, believed that they could win. They were inspired by the big revolutionary movement of the Arab world. There was an opinion poll that showed that more from 60% of the people that were asked believed that this movement could win the government, that the government would not pass the memorandum, because it was massive. But of course the government managed to pass the memorandum, and they voted, despite the small crisis they had. And after this there was a period of disappointment for many of the working class and the youth, that didn't last long. After this we had very massive working class struggles, general strikes that were really different than the previous period. These general strikes had massive support, and they were massive on the streets. Thousands of working class and youth went on the streets to demonstrate. And there was a difference in the political slogans. In the slogans, they were political this time. Not only, you know, fight for better wages, fight for better pensions, but down with the government and one political solution. And this was a very different language that the working class started to speak. That showed us, of course, that from the summer on we had a pre-revolutionary situation in Greece, which meant that the masses, the workers and the youth, wanted a change. They entered the scenery and they wanted to change the situation, but yet they didn't know, and they don't know how exactly they will change it. The movement of the working class reached its peak, I think, in February the 12th, where we had a massive general strike. 500,000 workers and youth went onto the street, only in Athens, in Sidamo. When I reached there, there were already, you couldn't move, because the people were tied together. There were singing, there was enthusiasm, there were occupied buildings of the public sector that the workers put phones and that were playing revolutionary songs with red and black flags. It was, you know, your hairs were up from this situation. A totally different mentality. People felt that they were strong. But of course there was no organization, no party, you know, controlled it, organized it. There were people just came onto the streets. And of course the government had organized a plan to evacuate the square and attack the demonstration. This was the day that the second memorandum was being voted. So they had about 400 provocators organized, it was clear that they were organized, started to attack in different places to the police, and the police then had an organized plan to throw tear gas in the square, and people fought inside the tear gas for a long time, but eventually they were defeated. And imagine the mentality of the people, 500,000 people on the street were defeated by a few thousand policemen and some a few hundred provocators. This put in the minds of the people that something, of the working class there, that something else should be done. That only going down the street and demonstrate won't solve the problem. There should be a political solution. And of course, I think that this day the idea of organized demonstrations of make groups for self-defense of the workers to defend against the provocators were essential, and they were are in the minds of many of the workers and youth now. But after this defeat and the second memorandum, the workers and the youth were very disappointed. There was a mentality of despair, especially in the vanguard of the workers. This expressed itself in the most tragic way with suicides of people of the vanguard of the working class. There was one pensioner that suicided in the Sidama Square, and he wrote a note saying that he attacked the government that was having all these attacks in the working class. And he said that if the youth would someday rise, he would be the one joining, but because he was too old, he has no other option than to kill himself. There were other incidents of trade unionists who suicided, who didn't have a serious problem with their lives. It wasn't suicide of despair because they couldn't live, but it showed just the political despair in the air of the vanguard of the working class and the youth. And the movement drew some conclusion, but in this period, and as I said, they said that we must now have a political solution. There must be a change of power, and this is a revolutionary element in the situation, which expressed itself in the vote, massive vote for SYRIZA and the collapse of the PASOK party. And the working class voted massively for SYRIZA. It was clear in the vote that in all the areas that there were workers who had a vote of SYRIZA of 32 to 35%, and PASOK, especially in these areas, collapsed to 5, 6, 9% out of 30 or 40. So there was a big swing of the working class to SYRIZA. The working class now believes that wants SYRIZA to become its tool to change things, to express itself in power. Of course, SYRIZA didn't win for only a few thousand votes, and this puts us in a new period of disappointment, but a totally new one. Now the working class have no illusions about the government. They know it's going to attack them hard. They know it's weak. It's a three-party government that could collapse any time. And they put their hopes in SYRIZA. But of course, SYRIZA has a program that it can't give any solution now to the basic problems of the working class, because it depends on some illusions. One of the main is that believes that the European Union, the capitalist European Union, will keep giving them money for them to do social policy, which is not going to, of course, to happen, because if Greece starts taking money from the European Union to give to the pensioners and the workers, then this Spain will ask the same, Portugal will ask the same, and the German bourgeoisie is not ready to do such a thing. And of course many other things. The main problem with the SYRIZA program is that it believes that capitalism can become friendly to the working class, and that all the crisis just misunderstanding that can be resolved with Keynesianism and Keynesian policies. That's of course it's not true. The only program that can give a solution to the working class is the socialist program, a program that will organize the economy in a democratic way, and of course a program that cannot give solution only in national limits, but in only if it implies itself in the whole of Europe. So we say socialist solution for Greece, and the socialist solution for the whole of Europe is the only solution for us all. Well, there are two metal industries. One here in Greece, in Athens, there is a metal industry of Greece, a steel industry of Greece, sorry. And they were having a strike for many months, more than 6-7 months. And because the bourgeois wanted to have severe cuts, he wanted for them to work only a few hours a day, and he wanted to sack many of the workers. So they decided that they will strike until nothing of this was passed, a defensive struggle. And they fought for many months. They gave a heroic struggle. The whole of the working class in Greece supported them. All over Greece, workers from unions send money, food, clothes. And there was also solidarity from the whole of Europe, from steel worker industries and steel industries and parties, and it was becoming a symbol, a strike that was a symbol for the working class in Greece and Europe. That's why it was very important for this struggle to be victorious, and I think that the Communist Party and SYRIZA should give all their emphasis for this struggle to be victorious. The main disadvantage of this struggle was that this industry had two factories, one in Athens, one in Volos, and because the Communist Party controlled the one factory and the PASOK controlled the other, they didn't collaborate with each other. And the Communist Party continued the strike, so the management just put all the production in the Volos factory. So they managed to fight against the strike successfully. Of course, because this was taking too long time and because it was becoming a symbol, the government decided that it was not just the problem of the management, but her problem, and decided to act to attack the workers of the steel industry, and sent the police to break the strike and the occupation, and it managed to break it. But of course the workers one day after decided that they should go on with the fight, they should continue. And after a few days of course, I think it was a bad decision, mainly from the Communist Party, to retreat, and said we can't go any further with the strike, we have to make a defensive retreat. What should be done is to make a major campaign for the other factory to go on strike. From the left, the left should put pressure for the other factory to go on strike. And of course, if the management wouldn't retreat to all the demands of the workers, this factory should be occupied from the workers and start working again under workers' control. That's what we believe should be done. Of course, now the warriors were defeated because they were misled. They gave a heroic fight for many months, and it led to a standstill. In a period of crisis, the demand for the steel industry is low. The management doesn't care so much about strikes, so the workers should put on more aggressive demands and even occupy work from themselves the industry. That was the only solution. Of course, there should be a political solution to this. For us, SYRIZA, when SYRIZA comes to power, should give a solution by nationalizing the industry, because the management is attacking the workers, is violating the workers' laws, and should put them in a plan of a nationalized economy. Then you have the example of the metal workers in Thessalonica, which occupied the factory and they're working it on their own after the management declined all their demands. And I think this is an example of what could happen in the next period in Greece, in many factories. We could have a movement of occupied factories in Greece in the next period. It could be a very big leap forward, because unemployment is 23% now, only in, officially. Unofficially, it's much, much bigger, and it's becoming an explosive situation. The occupation of factories could give hope and way out to the workers, and it could be spread out like fire very fast.
There's also a newspaper,
yeah,
which is now run by the workers themselves.
Well, yeah, this is Eleftherotypia. The workers there were struggling, were on strike for also for many months. The management declined all their demands, so they published some issues of their own. Of course, this was under very brutal attack by the state and the management. They tried to, with all means, to stop this, because also this was a very popular newspaper. So for the workers to publish their own had a political effect. And but the workers succeeded to publish some issues, and for a period they were publishing every Saturday the newspaper regularly with very interesting articles, and they visited workplaces to take interviews. Things they couldn't do with management, and but now they have problems with the bourgeois state. They're always under attack. With the management tried to close them down, so they can't publish anymore. There is also an example of alter channel. There was a channel that the management attacked again. The workers, he hired some, and he didn't pay for many months, most of the workers. So they decided to go on strike. Again, the management wouldn't do anything, and they decided to take over the station, the TV station. And they started to broadcast some their declarations of the union. For 1 month maybe, and after that they start make their own programs. They start to work the station again under workers' control, and they start make news of their own, visiting workers' places, taking interviews of the problem with the different workers, the workers' places problems, and of course this rang the bell, especially in the TV. From the state, and they were closed. They were attacked, and they closed the TV station.
Now, one feature of the crisis is the rise of the right wing. and the attacks on immigrant workers. So what is the situation there? And also, how do Marxists pose this question? What is the program of Marxists to counter the attacks on immigrants?
Well, the situation in Greece is worst for the immigrant workers that come here from the Middle East, the Arab world, Africa, where there are wars from Iraq, Afghanistan, for a better future maybe in Europe, and in reality they are trapped in Greece because wherever they go, the European Union says that they must go back to the country they first went. That's mainly Greece. So they are trapped in Greece in reality, most of them. There's a terrible situation for immigrants in the center. They're piled up in ghettos. Most of them don't have work. They are maintained by others. They live six or four together in a small flat. And they're in very, very bad conditions. And of course, the right wing takes advantage of this situation. Of course, if there are thousands of unemployed and in such a condition immigrants, we could have robberies and people are trying to find food. It's inevitable. If there is no social solution, it's an explosive problem. And this has been exploited by the bourgeois state. They use it to say you have to have security, more police. And the right wing, of course, the Nazis that took a big percentage in the last election are using it by making systematical pogroms against the immigrants. In reality, now we have a big pogrom going on from the Nazis and the bourgeois state. They call this pogrom the state calls it, the police calls it hospital zoos. Ironic, they are crazy. And the police is attacking the immigrants, they arrest them, and the Golden Dawn members attack them and with knives. They have physical attacks. One immigrant from Iraq was murdered, and many more were severely wounded in the last few days. This is a very, very serious situation for the working class. And the left, I think, should have long ago stand to this problem. I think one of the reasons that Golden Dawn has such a percentage, such a force in the parliament now, is because the left did not have any serious position on the question. What we believe, the Marxists of SYRIZA, is that there should be a campaign from the left and the trade unions in the ghettos to organize these people, to find them decent places to live, to have food for them, to connect with all these people, solve this humanitarian problem that they have. And so they can have also a connection with the people living in these areas, the Greeks that live also in a ghetto. They feel trapped in a ghetto, and the only one that seems to give a real solution to the problem is Golden Dawn, that says, okay, I will clear the area from the immigrants that are the problem. If the left had a serious attention to this situation, a serious policy, I think the Golden Dawn wouldn't be so strong. And there would be a much bigger connection with the immigrant workers that are some of the most militant workers in Greece, most oppressed, and some of whom will be the most militant in the next period. Now I think that it's never too late. SYRIZA should make also a big campaign to recruit immigrants in the party, recruit immigrants even if they are unemployed, even if they have work in the unions, to make an unbreakable bond with the Greek workers. And of course, we shouldn't rely on the police to fight them down, because the police is now proving that it's working together with the Golden Dawn. There are many witnesses saying that you know, policemen go together with the Golden Dawn members and attack the immigrants. There is a connection with the state and the Golden Dawn. They're working together, just using different means. What the police can't do, the Golden Dawn does. So the workers in Greece must organize, immigrants and Greeks, make groups to defend against these attacks in every area. In this way, they will attach much more with the immigrants that feel unprotected and not safe here. I think we will realize which is the balance of force here, which is much more in favor for the working class. In reality, there are a few hundred members of the Golden Dawn that do such things. That it's not a massive movement. In one day, they could be erased from the streets if the left, SYRIZA and the KUKUE, had a serious approach to this issue. So that's what we propose.